A very good evening to everyone. My name is Medha Rajiv Ranjan. I'm a first year BDS student from Savita Dental College and Hospitals, Chennai. So before starting my presentation, I would really like to thank IASR for giving me such a wonderful opportunity that I could present my paper on this platform. And this is my first live e-conference presentation. And I am here today to present my poster on the topic gender determination using odontometric maxillary measurements. Gender pertains to characteristics that differentiates masculine from feminine. So gender determination plays an extensive role in medico-legal cases wherein the external features of the individual, such as the physical characteristics of the individual, cannot be identified or distinguished easily. In cases such as natural calamities, mass disasters, severe incineration or road accidents, and so on. So previously, gender determination was carried out using parameters such as the interacromial length, the femoral length, and skull anthropometry. However, the human teeth, because of its excellent inert chemical structure and physical strength, is best preserved during any mass disaster. So this is where forensic odontology steps in with its excellent scope and in order to identify the gender of the individual, which is why I have chosen the topic gender determination using odontometric maxillary measurements using the second premolar. So for this purpose, my research study, I had conducted it on 60 volunteers, which included 30 males and 30 females with the help of a digital vernier caliper with accurate measurements. So the measurements were taken from the buccal aspect of one premolar to the buccal aspect of the other premolar. And the results which were obtained were tabulated using IBM SPSS software and chi-square analysis. So the results indicated that the interpremolar distance in males was greater as compared to the interpremolar distance in females. The p-value that I had obtained was 0.001, which is less than 0.05, which rejects the null hypothesis, and it indicates that the result which was obtained from my study was statistically significant, and therefore it can be concluded that gender can be determined using the odontometric maxillary measurement using the second premolar. Thank you.